Hey guys, so I'm sorry we couldn't be in class today to present, but we wanted to make a short video so that you could understand our topic and really learn about it because it's actually very interesting. So in our project, we focused on romance in Israeli films. And basically what we did is we chose 4 films from different times, and basically what we did was we focused specifically on what was happening during that time period and what influence it had on the romance in the film. So I hope you enjoy our presentation, and if you have any questions, you can comment in the online discussion forum that we created for you. Thank you.
I watched the movie I Love You, Rosa, and this movie was filmed in the late 1970s. Throughout the 1970s, there are many conflicts between Israel and neighboring countries, such as Syria, Jordan, and Egypt. Israel started a 6-day war in fear of the Arab countries attacking them. Although many people were worried about the wars going on, Israelis were still very traditional. They focused their lives on traditional Jewish values to comfort them and get them through difficult times. I Love You, Rosa is based on the idea of Nisim being required to marry his deceased brother's spouse, Rosa. This is required by the Jewish law of levirate marriage. Levirate marriage is when the survived brother is obligated to marry the deceased brother's wife and take care of her. At the time, Nisim is only 12 years old and Rosa distances herself from him. However, after a few years, Nisim matures and goes to find Rosa to prove his love for her. Eventually, Rosa grows to love Nisim too, despite his age difference. Jewish traditional laws taking place at this time period brought Nisim and Rosa together, despite the fact that many believe that Nisim was forced to marry Rosa because of levirate marriage. Overall, Nisim married Rosa because of true love and not because of Jewish religion. Rosa, who at first kept herself distant from him, also grew to love Nisim because he proved to her that he matured and he's a loving person.
The Dibuk of the Holy Applefield was created in
1989.
This film is based off the play created by S. Anski in 1914. Throughout the time period, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu won the election by a landslide. His main focus was to protect the security of Israel. His party was committed to protect the Oslo Accords, a peace agreement between Israelis and Palestinians. People in Israel were becoming more modernized and emphasized less values expressed in the Jewish religion. People were also becoming more acceptive of the differences between Israelis and Palestinians. The Dibuk of the Holy Applefield is based on the planned marriage Leah and Hanan's fathers had arranged for them from birth. However, Hanan's father passes away, causing Hanan and Leah to become separated. Years later, Hanan, a secular non-religious Jew, meets Leah, an Orthodox Jew. Through their time spent together, Hanan and Leah fall in love. Because Leah's parents refuse Hanan from marrying Leah, he decides to study Kabbalah, the study of how to receive fulfillment in our lives. Hanan gets tormented by Orthodox hoods sent by Leah's father, and he eventually dies. Before his death, Hanan and Leah envision the holy apple field, resembling a biblical image from the story of Adam and Eve. When Leah's at her wedding altar with another man, she tears the clothing from her body and addresses the congregation in Hanan's voice. Many people in Israel are more accepting of secular Jews. However, this movie portrays how Hanan and Leah prove their true love for one another. Despite the fact that Leah was about to marry another man, he comes back to haunt her to show her that she will never be able to get Hanan out of her head. This movie portrays how true love conquers all.
Hi everyone, so the time period I focused on was the 1990s. The 1990s marks a time period of constant fear of bomb scares and missiles being thrown by Iraqis during the Gulf War, which was from August 1990 to February 1991. Civilians were forced to live in constant fear and always had to be alert for to listen to sirens or to take orders from the Israeli Defense Force. The 1990s also highlights a time of major immigration to Israel, especially by Russian Jews. At first, the immigrants stuck to one another. They stayed like to themselves. They were very segregated in a way, I guess you can say. But soon after, like most immigrant groups that come, they soon after moved and associated with Israelis and started interacting with different people. So Yana's Friends is the movie that I watched. It was a film directed by Ari Kaplan, and it's set in Tel Aviv, Israel, immediately before and during the Gulf War, the 1991 Gulf War. While forced to wear gas masks during this fearful time, during all the things and the chaos that was going on, three romantic relationships flourished in this film. They were unraveled and they flourished in the film. The first relationship that is presented is between Yana and her roommate, Ellie. And Yana is a Russian immigrant. She comes with her husband. She's actually pregnant. And as soon as the Israeli government gives them the money that's granted to immigrants, her husband abandons her and goes back to Russia. So Ellie's the one to be there for her, to help her, to aid, to care for her, and they end up having a love affair and a relationship together. And the second relationship that is presented is between Alik and Nilou. They're Russian immigrants. Now that Alik and Nilou are living in Israel, they are forced to face the struggles that a lot of immigrants face when living in a new country. And they have financial struggles, different challenges, and they just want to be able to feed their family and have the basic necessities of life. And the third relationship, the romantic relationship that unravels, that is shown is probably the cutest one, is the rekindled love between Rosa, who is a Russian immigrant, the landlord of the apartment, and Mila's war veteran invalid father. He barely speaks, barely shows any emotion throughout the whole film, and when he rekindles with Rosa, he's like living again, and he's a totally different person, and smiling, and it was really amazing thing to see because they knew each other back then and they rekindled now. So the film truly opens the eyes of the audience to the difficulties and challenges that immigrants face, and especially Russian immigrants, when they move to Israel. And it teaches us truly the importance of treating them kindly, because it's really never easy moving to a new place, yet alone a new country across the world. And I would say the most important thing is that this is a romance film. And it's really important because we were a group of four girls, so like all we do right away, we wanted to work something with roommates, and we like watching things that people fall in love and getting the gossip and like that. But in reality, everyone likes to watch romance films, and they don't always own it, but they really do like to, and it attracts such a large part of the population. So it was an advancement in Israeli film because directors were able to speak out to a large part, population, and they were able to get the idea across that of what was going on in Israel during the time and how it affected everything.
Hey guys, so I'm sorry we couldn't be in class today to present, but we wanted to make a short video so that you could understand our topic and really learn about it, because it's actually very interesting. So in our project, we focused on romance in Israeli films. And basically what we did is we chose four films from different times. And basically what we did was we focused specifically on what was happening during that time period and what influence it had on the romance in the film. So I hope you enjoy our presentation. And if you have any questions, you can comment in the online discussion forum that we created for you. Thank you.
I watched the movie I Love You, Rosa, and this movie was filmed in the late 1970s. Throughout the 1970s, there are many conflicts between Israel and neighboring countries, such as Syria, Jordan, and Egypt. Israel started a six-day war in fear of the Arab countries attacking them. Although many people were worried about the wars going on, Israelis were still very traditional. They focused their lives on traditional Jewish values to comfort them and get them through difficult times. I Love You, Rosa is based on the idea of Nisim being required to marry his deceased brother's spouse, Rosa. This is required by the Jewish law of levirate marriage. Levirate marriage is when the survived brother is obligated to marry the deceased brother's wife and take care of her. At the time, Nisim is only 12 years old, and Rosa distances herself from him. However, after a few years, Nisim matures and goes to find Rosa to prove his love for her. Eventually, Rosa grows to love Nisim too, despite his age difference. Jewish traditional laws taking place at this time period brought Nisim and Rosa together, despite the fact that many believe that Nisim was forced to marry Rosa because of levirate marriage. Overall, Nisim married Rosa because of true love and not because of Jewish religion. Rosa, who at first kept herself distant from him, also grew to love Nisim because he proved to her that he matured and he's a loving person.
The Dibuk of the Holy Apple Field was created in
1989.
This film is based off the play created by S. Anski in 1914. Throughout the time period, Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu won the election by a landslide. His main focus was to protect the security of Israel. His party was committed to protect the Oslo Accords, a peace agreement between Israelis and Palestinians. People in Israel were becoming more modernized and emphasized less values expressed in the Jewish religion. People were also becoming more acceptive of the differences between Israelis and Palestinians. The Dibuk of the Holy Apple Field is based on the planned marriage Leah and Hanan's fathers had arranged for them from birth. However, Hanan's father passes away, causing Hanan and Leah to become separated. Years later, Hanan, a secular non-religious Jew, meets Leah, an Orthodox Jew. Through their time spent together, Hanan and Leah fall in love. Because Leah's parents refuse Hanan from marrying Leah, he decides to study Kabbalah, the study of how to receive fulfillment in our lives. Hanan gets tormented by Orthodox hoods sent by Leah's father, and he eventually dies. Before his death, Hanan and Leah envision the holy apple field, resembling a biblical image from the story of Adam and Eve. When Leah's at her wedding altar with another man, she tears the clothing from her body and addresses the congregation in Hanan's voice. Many people in Israel are more accepting of secular Jews. However, this movie portrays how Hanan and Leah prove their true love for one another. Despite the fact that Leah was about to marry another man, he comes back to haunt her to show her that she will never be able to get Hanan out of her head. This movie portrays how true love conquers all.
Hi everyone, so the time period I focused on was the 1990s.